Seeing London is one thing, but to get the most out of the city, you have to engage with it, immerse yourself in its energy, and explore. Venture off the tourist path and you never know what you might find. This is the Virgin Atlantic Guide to making the most of our beloved city. Accommodation in London is exemplary and often Anglo-centric. Here's some British hospitality at its best. A former car park in the heart of the city has been transformed into a hotel described as one of the most glamorous in the world. The Soho Hotel has an amazing bar and restaurant with the best of the rest on its doorstep. If an oasis of calm in the thick of it appeals, then this is the hotel for you. Once home to Hogarth, Dean Street Townhouse is a love letter to the decadence of the famous English painter. The very hip address is still pulling in the creative crowds, and its all-day dining room is surrounded by more contemporary works. The hotel offers great value for such high-end luxury. Alternatively, there can be few places to stay quite as unique as Living Architecture's City Dwelling. The boat, perched on top of the Queen Elizabeth Hall, was created to offer guests a place of refuge. Living Architecture have other one-off residencies to rent out of town. Staying further out of the centre can reduce hotel rates and provide quirky and eccentric insights into London life. The Tube makes light work of getting you back into town. In the heart of leafy West London, you'll find High Road House. The boutique hotel is an outpost of the ever-cool Soho House Group. And the well-priced rooms come with entry into the private members club. The very fashionable 40 Winks in the East End is a fantastical place to lay your head for the night. Staying is made all the more special by the tireless commitment of the B&B's owner, David Carter. This B&B feels just like staying in a boutique hotel, but without the hefty price tag. You can get around London as leisurely or as quickly as you like. The Tube is the best option if you want to zip around and make the most of your stay. But if you've got time on your hands, the bus routes still offer the best chance to see all the sights. A couple of iconic old-style Routemaster buses now run as heritage routes. Visit Transport for London's website for more information about the best way to get around the city. London hotels are still worth a visit if you already have your accommodation sorted. Head to the Sanderson for a decadent take on afternoon tea. At the Mad Hatter's Tea Party, you're invited to tumble down the rabbit hole and experience tea and cakes with a Lewis Carroll twist. Old school glamour waits for you at the American Bar at the Savoy Hotel. World famous cocktails have been mixed in this classic Art Deco joint since the late 19th century. And for the best views, dine at Galvin at Windows at the Hilton Park Lane. The restaurant is perched at the top of the hotel and has a jaw-dropping bird's eye view over the city. The restored St. Pancras Hotel is a beautiful example of Victorian Gothic architecture. Non-residents can take a tour around the building with a hotel's guide. Or visit a traditional barber on the platform for a haircut with a difference. Great plans are made in the Great British Pub. They are an integral part of British culture. so much more than a place to quench your thirst. Gordon's Wine Bar is thought to be the oldest wine bar in town and has been established in its present form since 1890. The cosy setting has not changed in decades, and historical references to the past adorn every wall. Sherries, Madeiras, and ports are served from the barrel. The wine bar was the former home of London diarist Samuel Pepys. The Dove is one of the most ancient settings to enjoy a good pint and a lazy afternoon along the banks of the River Thames. Over the years, the pub has been a frequent haunt of many a writer, including Graham Greene and Ernest Hemingway. The perfect pit stop after a picturesque amble along the riverbank. Nestled along the towpath of the Grand Union Canal, the Waterway pub feels a world away from the West End, but is only a few stops from Oxford Circus on the Bakerloo line. Its sister restaurant, the Summer House, located on a nearby houseboat, is famous for its delicious seafood. Food on the go is all the rage in London, and there are plenty of places to sample some top-notch street food. Grab a plate and head to the nearest open space for an impromptu alfresco dining experience. Whole areas have been taken over by a new generation of independent food lovers and producers. Stalls and shops are popping up all over the place, peddling the finest ingredients and culinary creations. Brick Lane's Sunday Upmarket is home to one of the most exciting food scenes in London. It's an experience like no other, as vintage stalls, music sellers and crafts pepper the old Truman Brewery. Industrious caterers serve up the most amazing dishes from all over the world. This is multicultural London at its best. Pizza East, nearby, is a modern take on the pizzeria. Based in the Tea Building in Shoreditch, it's a more leisurely alternative to the food offered at the stalls. The restaurant also serves brunch at the weekend. Borough Market remains London's most renowned food market and offers exceptional British and international produce. Check out the market website before making a visit for information on upcoming events and some amazing recipes from local traders. The market runs from Thursday to Saturday every week. For amazing Moorish-influenced cuisine, head to the Food Haven, Exmouth Market, where you will find the much-coveted Morro. For a more informal dining affair, pop next door to Morrito for the most delicious tapas in town. It goes without saying that London is a shopper's paradise. Here's our guide to London's hippest shopping postcodes. Put on your comfiest walking shoes and head to the back streets of the West End. The Bond Street area attracts the very best in boutique shopping. Many of the suppliers to the bigger department stores can be found here. Gray's Antiques Market is well worth an afternoon browse. If vintage isn't your thing, there are plenty of collector's items and one-off treasures on offer. Dover Street Market is dedicated to fashion and design. Cutting-edge brands are displayed like art installations at this groundbreaking store. Carnaby Street, Soho, and the surrounding streets are littered with contemporary and quirky boutiques. Check out Lazy Oaf for snazzy, art-inspired stationery and textiles. As well as looking good, their wares are guaranteed to make you smile. In the heart of Soho, you'll find YMC, master producers of unique workwear-inspired clothing. The brand's name aptly stands for You Must Create. The collections are stunning and include wardrobe staples that are designer spec at high street prices. Marylebone High Street is a village-like hub in the heart of the West End. Nestled amongst the cafes and bars, you'll find some top purchases. Daunt Books is a literary step back in time. The Edwardian building could make anyone feel like a scholar as they flick through their well-stocked shelves. Artisan suppliers to Selfridges, Sear, Trudon, have their flagship store here. And for all things cheesy, make a visit to La Fromagerie, one of many food specialist shops dotted along the high street. And Paul Smith, the brave knight of British design, has a shop here too. West side of the city, there's great shopping to be had around Portobello Road and surrounding area. Independent fashion doesn't get much better than at Wolf and Badger. Up-and-coming designers can showcase their wares here to style-savvy West Londoners. Chocolate lovers can get their fix with award-winning chocolatiers Melt. The chocolates are crafted in store, and the tempting aromas make it all the more impossible to leave empty-handed. Merchant Archive describes itself as a vintage and contemporary lifestyle shop that from humble beginnings now attracts London's top stylists, fashion designers, and celebrities alike. The achingly hip East End of town has a lot more to offer than skinny jeans and geeky glasses. Broadway Market is one of the most heartwarming places to be on a sunny Saturday afternoon. The stall holders design most of the wares on offer so you can get the full backstory of what you're buying. Handcrafted innovation at great prices. One such designer is Karin Andreasen, a jewellery and headpiece designer selling at the market every weekend. Old Spitalfields is becoming ever more commercialised, but the former fruit and veg market is such a beautiful space to browse. It's still well worth a visit. It continues to draw an eclectic crowd that rummage through the diverse range of goods on offer. Folk at Brick Lane is just one of a handful of brilliant smaller labels in the area. They focus on traditional British tailoring and quality finishes, a welcome antidote to the mass-marketed looks to be found elsewhere on the high street. London has so much on offer to enlighten and entertain. At any one time, there are infinite possibilities to be amused, dazzled, and delighted. Time Out magazine remains the best source of up-to-date information about what's going on and when. The West End will always be home to London Theatre, but for a more intimate experience, head to Shepherd's Bush. Located in a former library, the Bush Theatre is world famous for pioneering new plays and nurturing raw talent. The theatre boasts a beautiful bar and cafe and has ignited the careers of some amazing actors. South of the river, you will find the groundbreaking Meunier Chocolate Factory Theatre. A visit here offers every chance to catch a future West End hit. The much-loved Fringe Theatre also has an award-winning restaurant. Sadler's Wells has been a place of entertainment for over 300 years. It is now the UK's leading dance house, dedicated to bringing the very best of international and UK dance to London audiences. They produce the most amazing shows here. On the north side of the river, across from the South Bank, is Somerset House. The former naval residence has become a glorious backdrop and centre of excellence for art, music and entertainment. The Courtauld Gallery is home to masterpieces that could hold their own in any world-renowned gallery. And the central courtyard stages everything from music gigs to open-air cinema nights. Nourish your soul and head out on 2 feet to the South Bank Centre. A walk along the river here will take you through some of the most culturally exciting parts of the city. The 2012 Festival of London has put the site back on the map. There's so much to do here. You'll also find the BFI's IMAX Theatre. Once you've seen a movie here, it's hard to imagine experiencing cinema anywhere else. Keep heading east along the South Bank and you will pass the Arty Enclave, Gabriel's Wharf, the Tate Modern and Shakespeare's Globe Theatre. At Gabriel's Wharf, you can hire bikes and tandems from the London Bicycle Tour Company. Children's seats are free with adult bikes. It's the most eco-friendly way to explore the area. The South Bank is the perfect spot for people watching, and a short walk across the Millennium Bridge will take you to St. Paul's and other delights north of the river. You can also purchase a hop-on, hop-off ticket from the City Cruises Company for travel along the Thames. Pickup points are at piers along the river. London has some of the world's most famous artifacts and treasures housed in its world-class museums. However, it's worth exploring some of the more obscure locations for a true insight into how the city used to feel. Dennis Sever's house is one such very special location. The house was created as a time capsule by its fanatical former owner in the style of its original inhabitants, a silk weaving family from the East End. It's now open to the public, and a visit will give a sense of how the Huguenots lived through generations from the early 18th century. The motto of the house is Aut Visum, Aut Non. You either see it or you don't. John Hunter was a pioneer of evidence-based medicine, and his anatomical collection was dedicated to the Royal College of Surgeons in 1799. The Hunterian Museum is antiquarian, strange, and utterly fascinating. A must-see, but not for the faint-hearted. Sir John Soane's former home is now London's favourite museum, and it's packed to the rafters with fascinating artworks and artifacts. Every wall and mantelpiece of this incredible house is cluttered with the treasures and finds of the great architect and innovator. 70 square miles of London are made up of parkland. Head to the lungs of the city for some countryside-like experiences in the heart of the capital. The Bull and Last pub in Highgate, down the hill from the stunning Hampstead Heath, offers freshly made picnic hampers complete with homemade lemonade and a picnic blanket. Phone in advance to book the Wicker Pack delights before heading to the park. Check out the incredible views from the top of Parliament Hill. The Bull and Last is also known for the best roast dinners in London, and with open fires and micro-brewed beers, it can be a cosy place to while away a Sunday afternoon. There's no better way to take in Hyde Park than on wheels. The park is the spiritual home to London's skating community. Head to Club Blue Room for skate hire and protective gear. They can also put you in touch with qualified instructors from Skatefresh. Regent's Park is home to London Zoo. The zoo works closely with conservation projects around the world. Be sure to check out the squirrel monkeys and the penguins in their spacious beach condo. Feeding the penguins is still the highlight of any visit. While you're in Regent's Park, take the water bus to Camden along the canal for a serene route into one of the busiest weekend markets in Europe. London has many magnificent lidos to choose from, but London Fields' Olympic-sized pool is by far one of the most impressive. The Lido sits in the heart of Hackney and is on the doorstep of the artisans' quarter of Broadway Market. As the pool is heated, you can swim here, whatever the weather. London is fabulous in the sun, but if the heavens open, don't worry, London was built for days like these. Head to one of London's thriving independent cinemas. One of the oldest and still the best is the Prince Charles, just off Leicester Square, a real film lover cinema. They run cult classic nights as well as their popular sing-alongs. Or for a more opulent indie night at the Flicks, head west to Portobello Road, where you'll find the beautifully restored and very luxurious Electric Cinema. All Star Lanes is the best bowling alley in town. An authentic 50s Americana-style experience with great food, cocktails and shoes. Make like Kingpin and forget about the weather. A beacon of survival and hope. Sir Christopher Wren's masterpiece, the domed St. Paul's Cathedral, still dominates the ever-changing London skyline. There has been a cathedral on this site for over 1,000 years. It's worth the climb up to the Whispering Gallery. it's surreal and shows off the ingenuity of the acoustic design of this glorious place of worship, one of the best places in London to wait out the rain. Grab a post-cathedral cup of tea and a cake at the fantastic Bees of Bloomsbury. Or if you'd prefer to bask in the majestic cathedral's presence for longer, then dine at Jamie Oliver and Adam Perry Lang's Barbacoa. With stunning views, the restaurant serves the best barbecued dishes in town. You can also shelter from the rain with a spot of pampering at the Urban Day Spa at the Mandarin Hotel. Or for a truly British affair, try the Spa and Barber at Alfred Dunhill in Mayfair. The spa has the look and feel of an exclusive men's club, but there's nothing stuffy about it. You can book in for a shave while you sip on a tipple from the cellar bar. Although the barber's is men only, the spa treatments are open to women too. If you're travelling with children, there's plenty to keep the little tykes entertained and amused, even on the dampest of days. All the big museums have plenty to fascinate and occupy adults and children alike, and the majority of what's on offer is free, leaving more money for cake and the gift shop. With activity trails, including a trip to see the mummies, the British Museum is perfect for a rainy day out. The museum runs great events for families, so be sure to check out what's on offer on their website. And it's the gigantic dinosaurs that most impress young and old at the Natural History Museum. An extensive collection of stuffed animals, some now extinct, add to the wonders on show. Rain or shine, London works in all weather. This amazing city has something for everyone. We hope we've inspired you to get out there and get involved. Remember to check out the official tourist website, Visit London, for up-to-date information on what's happening around town. Have a fabulous trip, and thank you for watching.